Hi, welcome to Guideline Updates with MedStudy. I'm Dr. Paul Catalana. And linked on your screen is an updated article from the American Academy of Pediatrics and the Centers for Disease Control in regard to developmental milestone checklists. And as a reminder for all of us, during well-child checks, especially in infants and young children, it's vitally important to monitor a child's progress in regards to attaining developmental milestones. And this particular article reviews updated milestones that have been changed in several important ways that we'll review here in just a moment. First, however, let's remind ourselves of the difference between surveillance and screening. Surveillance is a longitudinal process that we all do, not only during well-child visits, but really during any visit, whereby we talk with parents and get their input in regards to their child's development, and especially during our physical exam, actually monitor and evaluate for attainment of various developmental milestones. And over time, we, along with input from parents, are able to continually assess a child's developmental progress. If there is concern raised, we then move on to screening. And screening uses validated tools that help us to, in greater detail, evaluate a child's developmental progress. And in addition, screening is recommended during specific ages as we care for children. So for example, at 18 months and 24 months of age, we use the screening tool MCHAT to evaluate children for autism spectrum disorder. Now, as the CDC and the AAP reviewed the previous developmental checklists, one issue that they identified was the fact that these former developmental checklists were based on the premise that 50% of children were expected to reach a particular developmental milestone. Now, on the other hand, 50% of children were not expected to have reached that particular milestone. And the concern there was that that might potentially delay the early identification and subsequent intervention for a child with a developmental issue. A so-called wait-and-see approach was really a reasonable approach to take if only 50% of infants were expected to reach a potential milestone. To try to decrease the possibility that a wait-and-see approach would be taken in a child who ultimately ended up having a significant developmental issue, these new surveillance checklists now are based on the fact that 75% of children are expected to meet the particular developmental milestone. With that change, it's much less likely that we as healthcare providers will take a wait and see approach, but rather much more likely that we will move on to using a validated screening tool or move on to an early referral for additional developmental evaluation. And in that, we will hopefully begin intervention for any young infant or young child with a developmental delay and positively influence his or her ultimate outcome. Now, there are some other changes that were made as well. There are four categories of milestones: motor, social, language, and cognitive. And within each of those four categories, some of the milestones have been moved to a different age group, and other milestones have been eliminated completely. In addition, some of the more vague language has been eliminated, such as may or beginning to. And the former CDC guidelines that included warning signs, the warning signs have been eliminated as well. We are also encouraged during all well child visits to ask parents whether they are concerned about a particular behavior or if they are concerned about a behavior that we didn't inquire about. Again, trying to generate an open-ended conversation in an attempt to get as much information from parents as possible with the ultimate goal of early and prompt referral for children at risk for developmental delay. Now, I might also mention that these resources will not only help significantly during well child visits, but I think for those of you who are studying for exam, this will be an incredibly helpful resource. Because one of the other things that has become apparent in for me in reviewing this article is that various resources that outline developmental milestones sometimes differ from one another. And this can be very confusing and sometimes frustrating for those of you who may be preparing for an exam. So again, if you refer to the link that's included on the screen, I think this will be an excellent resource as you prepare for exams, in addition to an excellent resource for your use during well child examinations. So this particular update is extremely helpful. And again, keep in mind that probably the most important change in this article is the fact that the developmental surveillance tools are now based on the premise that 75%, not 50%, of children are expected to meet this particular developmental milestone, and therefore a wait and see approach is probably much less appropriate than perhaps it was previously. Hope this is helpful to all of you, and thanks for joining us.